Now that we've learned the basic idea of a decision tree model, let's build out one over in Alteryx. What we're going to start with is the exact same input data plus select tool plus create samples. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to bring in a decision tree tool, which is found in our predictive category. The first thing I'm going to do is simply name the model. I'm going to simply call it DT Redeemer. I'm then going to select what field am I trying to target, which is going to be that Redeemer field. And the next thing I'm going to do is select my different predictor variables, which will be all the ones besides customer key, first name, last name, and the Redeemer fields. And some of the different model customization options are found in this tab, where the first thing that we can look at is the minimum number of records needed to allow for a split. So what this means is the smaller number that we choose here, the more splits that we're going to have in our decision tree. And the same thing for the minimum number for a terminal node, which is the next option. If we choose this number to go down, what we're going to have is simply more terminal nodes. These last few items are definitely more advanced, and we're going to just keep them simply by default. If you'd like to read more on them, please just refer over to the reading notes right below this section. So before I kick off this workflow, what I'm going to do is put browse tools after the R and I outputs, and we're going to examine them in the next section.